So welcome to St Michael's Sunday service here on the 9th of September 2012, and tonight's subject is Sara and her flame. So I'm Rachel Goodwin. I come and do services here every few months or so, and I work with the Ascended Master Sara, who is the daughter of Jesus and Mary Magdalene. And tonight I'm going to be talking about her flame, which is her archetypal energy that's represented by a flame. And I'll be sharing exercises with you and singing and doing all my usual stuff that I like to do. So I'll say a little bit about Sara and how I see her and how I work with her. I see her as an ascended master for the age of Aquarius. So she's working with us to help us move into this new age and to develop ourselves fully as divine beings here on Earth. So she's very divine but very material. She's in all of the spheres. So a lot of her work is about integration, and it's quite gritty. It's quite gritty work, but it's also is an extremely high vibration as well. So, yeah. So I wanted to share with you a bit of information about her flame and how that's been given to me. And this is a channeling I did couple of years ago, I think, and I just wanted to read some of this through, and because it's quite informational what I'm giving you, if you want to ask me any questions or I say something that sounds completely obscure, I'm quite happy for you to ask me to explain something a bit more clearly or you know, whatever, that's okay. So this is a channeling where I asked Sara what the point was of these flames, because you hear about different ascended masters having different flames and the Magdalene flame and so on. I wanted to kind of know what the point was. And this is I'll just read you out part of what the answer was that came through. And Sara was talking about creation, about when manifest creation was created, and she said that because we're living within linear time and space, the divine creation of humanity that was formed is still unfolding. But that everything was present in the moment of creation that will unfold. So creation is an ever unfolding thing. And then she said that we can see creation as being like a growing of a flower. And she said this isn't an exact thing, but it's an idea for us to kind of get our heads around, to give us a start of sort of working out what it is that they're talking about. And she said, first the seed starts to sprout because the right conditions for growth has been achieved. And then the shoot starts to grow upwards in the darkness, emerging into the light. And as the stem grows, the bud of the flower grows larger and larger until the day where it starts to open and reveal the beauty hidden inside. So you could say, although this is not an exact analogy, that the divine masculine, which is the Christ flame, is what is needed for the stem to grow tall and strong, straight and true. And then the divine feminine, which is the Magdalene flame, is what is needed to form the perfect bud with all the beauty therein. And then you could say that the joining of these two perfect energies into the union of a third energy, which is the threefold flame, is what causes the bud to reveal itself in all its true beauty. So with all the work I've done with Sara, there's this idea of the divine masculine and the divine feminine coming together to create a third energy where there's no separateness at all. There's a little bit more to this, but I just want to call those energies in just by chanting them. So I'm just going to chant the Christ energies in and the Magdalene energies in and then Sarah's energy in. So just sit and feel those energies come in. Om Jesu Christeya Paramatmane Purusharavataraya Namaha. Om Jesu Christeya Paramatmane Purusharavataraya Namaha. Om Mataram Mata Magdalena Mata Jagadamba. Om Mataram Mata Magdalena Mata Jagadamba. Om Shri Saraye Narayani Namostute. Om Shri Saraye Narayani Namostute. Om Shri Saraye Narayani Namostute. So chanting in those three energies in that way, I've called that the practice of the threefold flame, and I think it's on my website somewhere. I can't remember where now, but I've got some cards outside if you wanted to look it up. Just have a look through. So she goes on to say then that you could say that the saturation of the plant in each stage of its growth by exactly the right energy at exactly the right time is what causes everything to grow in the right way. So if the second energy came too soon, the bud would grow too big for the stem to support. And if the third energy came too late, then the stem would wither and die before the flower had a chance to unfurl. So, as all the elements were present in the original creation, the plan needed time to grow and unfurl, with each element being present in the right time, in the right place. And this is how the flames have assisted humanity in growing perfectly, because it's us that are getting grown. We're the flowers. And I think we're going to be hearing a lot more about Sara's flame in the years to come, and after I'm really seeing a big alignment happening with the solstice in December this year, and I think after that we're going to really hear much more. I can just feel that this energy is going to be expanding and growing and moving further and further out. So it's an evolutionary force, basically. And this is how various other teachers have seen the Christ light as an evolutionary force. So it's way beyond Christianity. But really here, and now we're moving into our next phase of growth, into the age of Aquarius. We're stepping into something completely new now and becoming I mean, it's from everything that's come before, but it's still something completely different as well. So I'm going to do a guided meditation with you now. But I wanted to, I brought some sprays with me tonight. And you, Sara, spray. This is a Mother Mary spray. And I wanted to spray these about, yeah, this Mother Mary one, but if anybody doesn't want to be sprayed, can you tell me? It's got essential oils in it, so if anybody's, you know, very sensitive or something, otherwise I'll give you one I can spray. So this is a vibrational essence that opens us up to divine love. So it's very soft and gentle. It smells nice. So just get yourselves nice and comfortable on your chairs. And just feel yourself breathing in. Feeling of peace. And breathing out any tensions from the week or from the day. And feel your feet firmly placed upon the earth. And feel how grounded you are here in this special place of sanctuary. And just imagine that any tension or stress is just flowing down, down through your feet, going down into the earth, where Mother Earth can take that energy and transform it into wonderful, fresh energy. To just let go of anything that you just don't want anymore. Breathe it out down into the earth. That's it, just letting go. Just feel yourself breathing in more and more peace. And as you continue to feel more peaceful in this way, you can imagine that you're walking along a path. And this path winds around and around. And you become aware that you're on an island, a beautiful island. And this path is winding around and round, ever spiraling inwards. Just imagine you're walking along that path. On a beautiful day. And this path is leading you to the center, to the heart of all things. Just imagine yourself just drifting calmly and peacefully along this path till you reach the centre. So eventually the path spirals to an end. And you find yourself in a rose garden. And in this rose garden, there's an abundance of beautiful roses, which are blooming. Some are still in bud, some have bloomed. Just notice what colour they are, how they make you feel. And just continue to relax and feel more and more peaceful in this place. And just allow yourself to rest there, breathing in this beautiful energy. As you soak up and absorb these wonderful feelings. In this place, you're completely safe, completely protected. All is well here. Just breathe in the sense, the sights and the sensations. And then you notice that this rose garden is actually planted in a circle. And there, right at the centre of the rose garden, is a beautiful patch of grass or something else that looks really inviting. And so you go and sit down in the centre of this rose garden. And there at the centre of this sacred space, Sarah is there with you. Her energy is in the centre of that sacred space where you are too. And in the circle around you, are Sarah's ministry of angels, glowing in beautiful colours. Just notice what these colours are for you. Just feel yourself there at the centre. And Sarah is showing you what the next phase of evolution means. And the energies that are coming in. She's showing you these things of this next unfolding and the beauty in the unfolding and what this means for humanity and for the earth and for yourself. And she might show you this as an energy or a feeling. Or or as an image, or as thoughts and ideas or words. Just notice whatever it is that's given to you. Maybe something very, very small, or something very large. Just notice whatever it is that's given to you. Just open your heart to let it in. And you could just keep on feeling more and more peaceful in this place, this rose garden. More and more safe and secure. Just notice whatever it is that's given to you. Sarah's sharing just for you. And then just hold these things in your heart, in this special place. So that you can bring them back with you from this magical island and this wonderful rose garden. Just soak up any more last images or energies that you need from this place, and then arise from the centre of the circle and look once again for the spiral path leading you outwards once again, back out into the world, but bringing all of these things with you. And see yourself walking back. Imagine your feet, one after the other, walking on this path. How that might sound as you walk on the path. How it might feel. Winding out, back to the edge of the island. And then when you reach the edge, bring yourself back to your normal levels of awareness. Back into full consciousness once again. Feel yourself in your body. And then when you're ready, open your eyes. Are we all back?
Yes.
How was that? So that's kind of got us into a good energetic space now. And we're going to work a little bit with Sarah's flame. So just for this exercise, I'm going to give you a little card to look at Sarah's flame on it. And this is from a painting that I have. It was done by a wonderful psychic artist called Cheryl Hall, and it really, really holds the energy. Of Sarah's flame. And I'm just going to tell you a bit more about it. Then I'm going to chant. I've learnt a new chant, and I'm just bursting with it. As soon as I got here, I thought, I just want to do that chant. Just want to do that chant. Mm-hmm. So this is a channeling that I did very recently. So I've known about this flame for a long time. It has just kind of been there, and I've looked at it every now and then. I have worked with it, and I do feel it has a powerful effect, but I've kind of been looking at it out the corner of my eye because it hasn't been the time to really fully get into it. But the time is coming to really work with this much, much more. So I'm quite excited, really, to come and share this with you. So I'll just read out a few bits of this. I'm doing a workshop in a couple of weeks' time with Sarah to get prepared for the shift in December, and we're going to be working with this a lot more and going into it a lot more deeply. But I just wanted to share a few bits of it. So this channeling, it's about us connecting to the light within us and connecting to our divine spark. And in some systems, the divine spark is seen as being held between the heart center and the solar plexus in a chakra called the Hri Padma. So this is Hindu. I've also seen it around in all sorts of mystery traditions and given different names as well. But so she's talking about this divine spark and us connecting to the light within. And I'll just read you some of this channeling. And she says that connecting to the light within has been a challenge for humankind, especially in more recent times. But now this is changing and becoming easier. Through my flame, you can be assisted to connect to your own divine spark. I am a bridge to the Christ consciousness and can help you feel your own divinity and be your own divinity. Mankind is alchemizing his own lower denser energy, so like the heaviness of matter, really, making use of the unmolded clay and making it into something finer. Through the weaving of the light and the dark, so the light becomes heavier and the dark becomes lighter, so they can both come into oneness, a being in the same place, and there's no separation then. And then she gives us an exercise to work with this flame and kind of overlay it to our own divine spark. So that's what we're going to do. First of all, I'm going to chant to you. And this is it's a clearing chant. So if you just imagine you've got a divine spark, and just think of where your heart centre is, and think of where your solar plexus is, and just imagine that point in between. So it's about two fingers width underneath your heart centre. So it's sort of here. And just breathe into this space. Now, you can see it as a chakra. It's not really a chakra in the same sense of our other chakras, but it's sort of held within a shell, which is why, you know, everything that's within us that's not of the divine consciousness is what forms that shell. So when we become kind of fully enlightened, that shell disappears, and then, you know, we're enlightened beings, we're our higher selves here on the earth. So, you know, this is where humanity is. We're going through this clearing process of clearing all that's not in accordance with the divine in our thoughts and our lives and our behaviour and our consciousness. So the chant that I'm going to do for you first, it's to help clear that shell. So anything that's ready to go from you right now, so anything you've kind of been working with and, you know, going through it day by day or year by year, or, you know, there's something that's just ready to go now because of the effort you've kind of put in, it will just, this, the energy of this chant will just come through and just clear it away. And then we're going to work with Sarah's flame to sort of, this practice to sort of align us more to our divine spark. So, I mean, the energies that you receive will be whatever is kind of good for you, basically. It'll come in as powerfully or as gently or, you know, as whateverly as you need it to be. So this is a Sanskrit chant, and I'm going to sing it through three times. And then I'll just let you sort of have a bit of a rest for a few minutes before I go on to work in the flame. So all you need to do is just close your eyes and just breathe into that space. And just imagine that's where your divine spark is, between your heart centre and your solar plexus. Bhukrutun namaha kaya surya koti sama prabha nira Namaha Settles a bit. I'm going to give you a little spray of Sara's energy now. So we're working to connect more deeply with our own spark of divinity. We've done a bit of clearing work there, and some things have been lifted away. And I'd like you to just gently gaze at that picture of Sara's flame. Just imagine it sitting over the top of your own divine spark. Just imagine you're breathing that flame in, into that divine spark. And so your own divine spark is kind of growing brighter and brighter, stronger and stronger. And you can do this for as long a time or as short as time as feel right, because actually it's a very powerful practice and can really only need just a few moments for that to be enough. So really go with what you're guided, what feels good to you. And while you're doing that, I'm just going to tune in and just ask Sarah if she wants to bring us any words this evening. And while I do that, you can carry on working with this flame if you want to. So I'm going to channel Sarah now. Welcome all, I am Sarah. This evening I bring you blessings in the form of my energy. As this flame pours out and overlays your own divine spark, so you are drawn and magnetized more and more towards being yourselves. This is humanity's greatest lesson now, to simply be more of themselves, to find and discover and tap into what is within each of you, your own unique individual essences. And this is my gift. My gift to you is to make you more of who you already are. This is the path to dynamic peace, balance, integration, happiness, prosperity, abundance, all of these things that you long for. And this is the path, not to simply know these things, not to simply know that you are love and find those things that make you joy, full of joy and joyful, but to feel it within every particle in your being, to live being that joy. So much has been cleared. And so much still needs to be cleared in the collective unconsciousness of humanity, in each of the ancestral lines. But in this clearing, will you discover all of these wonderful, beautiful, divine gifts? The light is held within the darkness. And all is well. All is well. All is well. But this next phase of your evolution will unlock much of what has been hidden before. And it may seem that the darkness just seems to come up ever more and be ever more present, and you may wonder, is this really how things are getting better? But then as each step is made and each progress is made, you'll feel lighter and clearer and more centered and more yourself. And you'll know all is well. All is well, all is well. And then when the challenges come up, actually, it won't seem so difficult. You'll take them in your stride as you become stronger and more of who you truly are. I am Sarah, and I have come here to assist humanity in its work. And I am forever at your side, and I am always here to add my presence and power, should you wish it. I am working through all of those who call upon me, coming through you and to you in a way that is physical. Through each of you, I am manifesting this Christ flame, this new energy that is coming here now. This unity consciousness, oneness. Blessings are upon you each and every day of your lives. Blessed be, blessed be, blessed be. Amen. So for the last few minutes, and I'd like to just invite you to just reflect upon what you've received in this time. And maybe if you'd like to, just take a card which might have a, you know, a message for you. And just, you know, kind of be with it. In a few minutes of quiet contemplation. And also, if you pass the cards back to me, the flame cards, that would be lovely. Thank you. If anybody wanted to look any of the cards up, there's a little book there at the front as well.